on 31st December 2019, when the world was waiting for the New Year crackers, a devil was born in Wuhan.
WHO has been assessing this outbreak. 19 can be characterized as a pandemic.
आज रात 12 बजे से संपूर्ण देश में संपूर्ण लॉकडाउन होने जा रहा है।
Our topic of today is COVID-19, the reality of COVID-19 we disclosed in this interview. So stay tuned. Coronavirus is a positive single-stranded RNA virus. Its outer membrane is made up of lipids and membrane proteins. Outer spikes mentioned over here, these outer spikes are made up of glycoproteins. This outer spikes are the most problematic and the main reason of this pandemic. Now basically coronaviruses are of four types. It is alpha, beta, gamma and delta. But they didn't disturb the mankind, as from those early 1960s human coronaviruses were detected, which caused minute cough, cold and fever. Approximately 2% of the entire population of the entire globe were healthy carriers of human coronaviruses, but they didn't disturb the mankind. Approximately 5-10% of all the acute respiratory diseases are due to coronaviruses. SARS-CoV, MERS-CoV and nCoV-19 all belong to human coronaviruses, which belong to beta category of the coronaviruses. The most interesting part of this entire module is about the origin of this COVID-19 virus. But before knowing it, as it is one of the most interesting and mysterious topic till date across the entire globe, let's know something more. Coronaviruses were not considered so harmful before this COVID-19 pandemic. In the year 2002 to 2003, SARS-CoV-1 was discovered, which caused a great pandemic, followed by MERS-CoV in the year 2012, which proved that coronaviruses are harmful to human beings. But generally, these coronaviruses were not so much harmful, as they were not so widespread across the globe. But this COVID-19 is having a very high spreading rate, and due to which this entire world is in a lockdown at present time. SARS-CoV-1 and MERS-CoV got huge number of patients and huge number of deaths too. But what happened on 31st December 2019? That a new virus, the researchers think to be 96% similar with RATG-13. This is a bats virus. This RATG-13 was a known virus which is having a similar appearance, but it is a virus of the bats, not of the humans. It doesn't belong to the HCoV categories, that is our human coronavirus categories. But scientists got some new ideas that somewhat this RATG-13 virus, which originated in the bats, transmitted to pangolin, which is one of the most trafficked animal across the globe. Researchers came to know that on November 2019, probably this virus has got a new modification on its glycoproteins, enabled it to synthesize some proteins which helped it to enter the human beings. This is one of the most accepted theories till now, as because scientists are doing their level best to find out the exact answers. But till now, it is the most accepted one. Researchers state that a spike mutation which occurred approximately at the late November 2019, it's jumping from the animal to humans, and at this moment it is spreading from human to human, as at this moment it is being termed as a airborne disease which is spreading the help of aerosols. Now we are going to deal with the most important topic of this entire module, which is the mechanism of action of coronavirus novel coronavirus humans cells. Is basically being transmitted from person to person. If a person is sneezing, coughing or anything, it may even spread through touch, which we all know from the basic science which we are being aware of via government. Now what is the main phenomena acting over here? The COVID-19 virus hampers the trachea and the alveolar cells. The cilia of the trachea and the alveolar cells get most hampered by this. Now suppose this to be a human trachea cell. This human trachea cell is having the nucleus over here with our genetic material, double-stranded DNA. This is the nucleus. Suppose this to be the lysosome, which we know to be containing hydrolytic enzymes which are mostly acidic. The pH over here is approximately 4 to 5, and suppose here is the ribosome. Now these three are the main functioning part which helps the COVID-19 virus to multiply in a human body. Suppose this is our COVID virus, which looks something like this with spikes all around. Genetic material or the genome of this virus is positive single-stranded RNA, which we have made you aware before. Positive single-stranded RNA is having the capacity of creating its own proteins and multiplying itself without entering the nucleus of the host cell. It can multiply itself just by entering the cytoplasm. So what happens is that human cells are having a receptor which is termed as angiotensin converting enzyme 2 receptor. This angiotensin converting 2 receptor is the receptor which is responsible for angiotensin converting enzyme 2, which is related to our blood pressure regulation. Now what happened in late November 2019, some spike mutation which helped this COVID-19 to secrete the human proteins which help this virus to attach with this ACE2 receptor. Normally what should happen, if this virus was not present, this human cell with ACE2 receptor will bind to only human proteins, as it is not made for other proteins. But this virus had made some modification in its glycoproteins, in the spikes, that helped it to secrete or synthesize some proteins which helped it to bind with this ACE2 receptor. When this COVID-19 virus gets attached with this ACE2 receptor, it forms a vesicle over here which looks something like this. Now it enters in this vesicle by rupturing this, enters over here. Suppose it has entered over here now. What happens after entering this vesicle? It simply fuses with this lysosome. After fusing with this lysosome, which is having the acidic content, membrane proteins on the lipids of this virus get dissolved and spread out to the entire vesicle. And as it spreads out to the entire vesicle, the genetic material present inside this virus also gets the capacity to directly enter our cytoplasm. So as it fuses with the lysosome, it enters our cytoplasm. Our cytoplasm is basically made up of 70 to 90% water and some proteins. Okay, so it is having a great capacity to hold some external materials also. So by getting that facility, this virus enters over here. Our human cells tries to inhibit the entry of the virus by secreting some proteins, but the virus synthesizes protease enzyme which totally digests our human proteins and gets its free entry to the cell. As it enters in the cell with the help of protease and its own RNA dependent RNA polymerase, it replicates its genetic material to 1000 times. As the cell gets that huge number of huge copies of this single-stranded RNA, this and proteins are also synthesized with the help of this RNA and process of transcription. After entering this cell and using our RNA dependent RNA polymerase, it totally replicates its genomic material to 1000 times and even more of it. Totally transcripts its single-stranded RNA copies, some of it to proteins. So as it is getting RNA as well as protein, which are the basic requirement for creating new copies, so inside the cell, new virus copies arise. Something like this. Multiple copies out there. And as so many copies get tied up in the cell ruptures and bursts. As the cell ruptures, this virus particles spreads out to other cells and proceeds the same process. And due to this continuation breakdown of the cells, our trachea cells get damaged as well as the alveolar cells. Now, due to this damage, the patient which is suffering from COVID-19 gets severe pain in the trachea and the lungs and even acquire pneumonia-like symptoms, due to which the patient may require ventilators too for proper respiration. In this way, the COVID-19 enters our human cells. Incubation period of COVID-19 is between 3 to 7 days. So in simple words, if a person is COVID positive, they will come to know about it in between 3 to 7 days, but it may also extend more to 12 days as some cases are seen unknowingly contamination may rise. According to the data of ICMR, if a person who is having COVID is not isolated, then a single person in 30 days of time can infect approximately 406 persons. According to WHO guidelines, it can stick on normal surfaces and may sustain over there till 1 to 4 hours in normal conditions and can spread the disease. Despite of the fact that data speaks that more contagious the virus, less mortality rate it has having. But the problem over here is in a huge population like the subcontinent of India, less percentage is also a huge part of our population. So it is the prime concern of the mankind to be safe. As we have discussed earlier, that the membrane of COVID-19 virus is made up of lipids and membrane proteins, and the spikes are made up of glycoproteins, and these glycoproteins and membrane proteins are soluble in 75% ethanol mixture as well as in ether and in fatty acid mixtures too. So sanitization and washing our hands without any delay of time as we touch any outside substance, the first thing which we have to do is sanitize and keep the surfaces disinfected. It has a huge recovery rate too. Huge percentage of the COVID patients in our country and across the globe have already recovered. Despite the fact that mortality rate is less, we have to be concerned about it and the safety measures are to be followed at their level best. At the moment, therapeutic strategies to deal with this situation are only supportive, and prevention aimed at reducing transmission is our best weapon till the date we get some antidotes of it. So be hygiene, clean and safe. If you have liked this video, then don't forget to share it and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon just beside. We are launching with a new channel in our system where we'll be dealing with the foundation courses. So also subscribe to the channel. The link will be given in the description box. So stay tuned and be safe.